Hey guys, welcome to Telecom Talk with JSA. I'm Jason Ellie, the Social Media Marketing Director of BroadConnect Telecom. And I've got with me...
Joseph Smith, as before, not believable, but it is still true, from BroadConnect Telecom as well.
And today we'll be talking about SIP trunking. What is SIP trunking? What are the benefits of SIP trunking?
That's a very good thing to bring up because a lot of people use the term SIP and it's a very broadly used term, and it does mean different things depending on the conversation you're having.
That's right.
For the purposes of our conversation today, it's more SIP trunking, not SIP integration,
right,
regarding phones to phone systems and that kind of stuff.
So can you briefly explain what a couple of advantages are as opposed to the conventional methods like analog lines?
Absolutely. I mean, SIP trunks for small businesses provide tremendous advantages. Mm-hmm. Cost reductions. You've got other things like in terms of adding services. Mm-hmm. That can now be done typically within 24 to 48 hours.
Right.
So if you had four lines yesterday and all of a sudden your business booms and grows, well, we can add SIP trunks pretty simply.
Right.
By just turning on additional channels for you. If you've got the back-end infrastructure with all your SIP licensing, that's the only other thing you gotta do is add the SIP licensing for it and you're good to go. Mm-hmm. Whereas before, we'd have to order the line, that line would take, maybe 5-10 business days for it to be installed, and then you have to call your technician to come out and install it into your phone system.
That's
right. So there is a big time advantage to SIP trunking and cost, because right, those analog lines have install fees with them and associated costs along with the technician programming and everything else. So SIP trunks are definitely a lot simpler, mm-hmm, on that aspect and a lot more cost effective.
What about PRIs?
Actually, why don't I step back, because I did forget a couple advantages which do roll into the PRI aspect of things as well with, mm-hmm, regards to SIP trunking, especially
right,
for small businesses,
right,
which are, with traditional phone lines, typically, you've got four lines, you've got one main number that's displayed when you call out, mm-hmm, and you can make and receive those four calls.
That's right.
Well, with SIP trunking, the other advantages are, for small business, they can mimic or act as if they were like a larger company.
That's right.
In the sense that I can now have DIDs, which you can't do on analog lines. Mm-hmm. And those DIDs are direct inward dial numbers. So you'd have your main number listing, and then I can have my own personal phone number that somebody would call, and it'll ring directly down to my phone.
That's right.
So you can now, if you've got 20 people, but you only had maybe, 8 phone lines before, provide them with DIDs, ultimately making it seem as if you were a larger company, because in the past, it's only been the larger companies that have had the ability to do that because they were installing PRIs, which is what
right,
our next conversation is going to be about. Well, from PRI to SIP trunk, the advantages are cost, once again,
mm-hmm,
and also ease of implementation and capacity, because on a PRI, you can have 23 simultaneous phone calls.
Mm-hmm.
Well, when we're providing SIP trunk service, if you're at the level of a PRI, we would install what's called a data T1.
That's right.
For the connectivity piece to connect the, mm-hmm, SIP trunks into your phone system. And that data T1 allows us the ability to put 39 simultaneous calls,
mm,
on that data T1, as opposed to the 23 that you have with PRI.
Right.
So right there, that gives you a big advantage, because most organizations, when they were at 23 lines, let's say they're growing and they had to add 4 or 10 additional lines, they would either add analog lines in conjunction with the PRI,
mm-hmm,
or they would install a partial PRI or have to install a full PRI for those additional 10 lines.
I gotcha.
So cost-wise, that just goes through the roof.
That's right.
Whereas for us, we have those 23 channels, but we can also add the additional up to 39 for your services.
Awesome.
Off one data T1. Cost advantages are tremendous. And you don't have to wait the big time lag to have those lines installed, pay the big install fees. So there's tons of advantages to the SIP PRIs, mm-hmm, with regards to those kind of services as well.
Another question now. What is the difference, or what is the advantage of SIP trunking over a hosted PBX system?
Well, I mean, traditionally, like, so if businesses have, or most businesses probably do have a premise-based phone system. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, some of the advantages to the hosted are, well, especially with BroadConnect, I don't know about everybody else out there, but we can actually install our SIP trunks with what's called an ATA, which is basically a IP to analog converter.
That's right.
And basically mimic an analog CO line for you, or an analog line. So now you don't have to upgrade your back-end technology. You know, if all you need is phone line services and you're not looking at additional features, then that's definitely the great way to do it. You know, whether you have an IPPBX and have the SIP trunk licensing to do it, or you don't and still want to take advantage of the cost factors and maybe DIDs and that kind of stuff,
right,
we can definitely implement that through the ATA solution as well.
Amazing. And let's talk about business continuity.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I mean, you know, that's a big thing for businesses, mm-hmm. especially with, you know, numerous blackouts or floods and
that's right.
other things that have been happening, exactly. you know, in North America. So with SIP trunking allows us the flexibility to be able to take those numbers at a whim and redirect them wherever it is that you'd like. Mm-hmm. And so what that means is, you know, if you don't have access to your facility, I can redirect those calls to your cell phones. Mm-hmm. I can redirect them to an alternate facility or a DR facility,
right.
or a business continuity facility. and I can do it quickly and simply. Mm-hmm. It's, you know, a couple keystrokes and we're done. You know, whereas through analog lines and PRIs, you can't necessarily do that all the time. You have to have the call forwarding feature as a, you know, one of the features on your analog services. And if you don't, then they have to add that. That takes time.
Yes.
All time that you need to be up and running.
I just got a tweet. Oh, they're asking me, are you gonna need extra bandwidth with SIP trunking?
That's a great question. And so the answer is yes. Each SIP trunk does require, when it's uncompressed, although we do compress all of our data and voice solutions, uncompressed, a voice conversation typically takes about 64 kilobits. So if you have 10 lines, you're gonna need 640 kilobits. Hmm. And it's typically not the download that we worry about, it's always the upload.
Right.
So, you know, if you're only running your business on an ADSL today, or, you know, if you've got a data T1, you may wanna look at an alternate internet connection mm-hmm. for that service. Or if you've got a big enough pipe, like fiber, in your premise, we can actually use your existing fiber and you bring your own bandwidth.
Amazing. So why should an SMB or even enterprise choose BroadConnect for their SIP trunking?
Well, I mean, businesses should absolutely choose BroadConnect based on our diversity mm-hmm. and our ability to be able to work with the multitude of different back-end technologies, integrate our SIP trunk solution with them, whether it be on a SIP level or whether it be you have an older phone system that you just want to take advantage of those savings, BroadConnect has the know-how to do it.
Amazing.
Yeah.
All right, Joe. I think that pretty much answers all the questions I have for you.
Awesome.
Anything else you want to plug?
No, other than, you know, if you're in the market and looking for some definite advantages for cost savings and or, you know, business solutions, feel free to give us a call.
You can join the conversation on social by hashtagging Telecom Talk, or you can follow us on Twitter, Facebook, Google+, Pinterest, and just search BroadConnect. You can find us there. You can also contact us toll free at 1-877-228-6616 or locally at 416-637-2461. And as always, you can catch us online at www.broadconnect.ca or broadconnectusa.com.
Awesome.
All right. Thanks a lot, Joe.
Hey, thank you.
Hey, this is Jason from BroadConnect Telecom. I'm the Social Media Marketing Director. And what I'm assuming is, if you guys are watching this video, you've probably got a bunch of questions about what a hosted PBX system is and what exactly it does. So I've got my friend here, Mr. Joe, a Senior Account Manager, to help us along with that.